sorry, Bishop, it says 12:8, it says, Future Home of Word of Life, United Methodist Church, Spring of Life, United Methodist Church. I turn right, and I go past the elementary school. I go down another half a mile, and the church plant is living in this community. Across the street from his house is the golf course. So I sit down, and we start talking about his church plan and this and that. And I said I couldn't help but notice the golf course. I was probably twitching by that point. I couldn't help but notice the golf course. Do you play golf? He says, well, I used to play golf. I grew up, played on the high school golf team. He said, but now, here's the thing. These are the words that came out. But, you know, now I'm a minister. Now I'm a minister. He never saw the connection. Church planter. So we had a little discussion about that, and then I went on my way. That night, one of the other pastors called and had to cancel the next afternoon, so I got a whole afternoon. See, so now I'm really twitching. So I call him up and say, hey, are you free? He says, yes. So I said, well, let's go to the place of golf. Well, I had to kind of twist his arm into doing that. I tried to make it sound like work, because he just had been so programmed that he was fun. So we go across and kind of dust off the golf club that I rented some, and we played around in golf. I can tell he played golf a little rusty, but we had a great time. So afterwards, I said, let's go and meet the pro. So we walk in, and I say to the pro, I said, do you have a clergy discount? He says, what do you mean a clergy discount? I said, well, you know, for ministers who play their course all the time, you know, do you have a discount for me? He says, I've never heard of such stuff. He said, we don't have that. I said, do you know this man is a minister in your community? I said, you know how many people, you know, that he would know that would come to this golf course to play golf with him? I said, I got 15% from the guy. All right, then he says, it's still going to cost $1,500. So I emailed the district superintendent. Dear sir, we need to have $1,500 per day to join this golf course so we can network in public. Oh, my goodness. Oh, Lord have mercy. His sanctimonious letter, I got that in that day. Oh, my God. Jim, good God honoring United Methodist give every week to their offering. They don't want that offering squandered on some pastor playing golf. We're asking that pastor to plant a church. I emailed him back. I said, I guess that means no. Hey, that doesn't stop church planters. We wrote to friends and family and raised up $1,500. He paid to join the course. This was like in April. Up comes June, the first scramble, right? Dave walks across the street, puts some money down, and gets in the scramble. On the fourth hole, somebody says to them, hey, what do you do? He says, well, I'm a United Methodist minister in the area. And one of the guys says, the church meeting at the middle at the elementary school? He says, yeah, that's the one. Turns out this guy was a committed United Methodist. He and his wife had relocated from Ohio, and in the 9 months that they've been there, they really haven't settled on a church, and so they started talking. The next Sunday morning, this guy and his family, this guy and his wife and his three children show up at the church. Not only was he committed to bishop, he tithed, and he hadn't tithed in 9 months. He wrote a check to that church for $5,000.